What's the most exciting part of a roller coaster ride? Part that really keeps you coming back for more? For me, it's the humps. The humps are the most important part of a great roller coaster ride. Those things that make you fly up out of your seat and wonder if you're even going to make it back to ground to tell your friends. Well, that's the same principle in surface texture. To me, the most interesting part of many surfaces are the humps that are hiding inside the surface. For this case here on the right, the humps themselves are much, much bigger than the kinds of features that we would consider roughness. The humps, being waviness, dominate this surface. If I were to press another surface against it, it's not the roughness that would matter, it's the waviness that would dictate the fact that we only have two or three points touching. So this is the case in many, many applications. In cases of sealing, in cases of noise of bearings or gears, in cases of stress concentrations, waviness can be our most important factor. So let's talk about how we might explore waviness on a surface, and you might be able to control it on a drawing of your own. So here's a surface. This will be a primary profile. It's leveled. It has a little bit of filtering applied, and we want to understand or exploit the waviness so we can control it. The way we do this is to take a little chunk of data and plot the average. Now we're going to do a special average. We're going to do a Gaussian weighted average where the middle points get a little more credit, but we're going to slide this average through the surface one point at a time. And as we do this, we will generate a smooth curve that is our waviness profile. This waviness profile can then be removed and looked at by itself. We can look at roughness above and below, but what we've done is we've smoothed our way through the surface with a specific width of a moving average. This specific width will actually relate to a specific wavelength where waviness begins. So we have a surface that's made up of lots and lots of wavelengths, and what we've done by choosing this width is we've set up a world where waviness is going to be these long wavelengths. Waviness has zero of the short wavelengths, 0% of them get through, but 100% of the long wavelengths make it through. This is a transmission curve, and perhaps this is for a 0.8 millimeter filter cutoff. So at 0.8 millimeters, we're using a moving average this wide to smooth through the data. Perhaps I'm interested in longer wavelengths. Maybe I'm interested in wavelengths that are maybe 2.5 millimeters and longer. That would mean I would use a wider moving average, and I would slide that moving average through this surface and perhaps exploit or extract a different shape of waviness. In any case, we're going to extract this shape of waviness, and let's go back to the blue one, and we're going to maybe look at the peak to valley height of that waviness profile, and that is reported as waviness total, WT. So the most common way of specifying a waviness control is this waviness total parameter, WT, and it might look like this on a drawing. We might use the ISO 1302 convention and say, here comes an upper limit, and we're going to look at wavelength 0.8 millimeters and longer. 0.8 millimeters and longer are going to be our waviness. That's perhaps the humpy one here. And we're going to look at the WT parameter, and we'll put a limit on that. Perhaps we'll say 5 micrometers is the limit where our parts start to fail. So this is how we would go about doing a waviness analysis and turning it into a waviness specification. We would smooth through the surface, we would find the humps on the roller coaster ride at a given filter that exploits them, and then we would specify a limit on total waviness using those wavelengths. To understand your waviness more, if you'd like to talk about this or other aspects of your surface, please reach out to us at digitalmetrology.com.